this episode, I make a terrible mistake.
Creeping finger? That sounds bad, doesn't it?
Gotta meet my dealer.
What kind of a dealer?
Did you bring the money?
No. What?
And it really pulls you into that scene, creates depth, and ultimately takes you on a journey.
It was pretty easy, actually. Yeah. But hey, thanks for the tip.
What an absolutely spectacular landscape.
Yeah, I think that's pretty good.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll have those then.
After a full 10 hours of driving, it was a sweet, sweet joy to finally stretch our legs and hit the trail. And on this day, we were on an adventure to the desert because, according to legend, this canyon holds a beautiful secret. Now, if you've ever wondered why I speed up this trail footage, well, it's just to make me look fitter than I truly am. Within 40 minutes, we arrived at this spectacular overlook.
Oh man, I absolutely love the desert. Now, if you had to guess as to where I am right now, you might be thinking Colorado, maybe Utah, maybe even California or Southern Oregon, but no, this is British Columbia, Canada. Now, when you think of British Columbia, you probably think of the coast or the rainforest or even the mountains, lots and lots of green. You don't think of desert and hoodoos like this. What an absolutely spectacular landscape. And I'm on the Gold Rush Trail. And this beautiful blue glowing river that you can see behind me is the Chilcotin River. Do you know what the biggest challenge is being a landscape photography vlogger? It's getting the shot and filming all of your B-roll. So every single time I come out to shoot, I don't know if I'm gonna get a shot or not, and often I don't. And there's so many vlogs that I film and you never even get to see them because there was no shot or nothing that interesting happened, and they just end up in the trash. But this vlog, I filmed a whole bunch of B-roll, I got some nice drone clips, and then I arrived and the clouds opened up and I had to make a choice. Do I vlog or do I take the shot? And of course, I'm a landscape photographer first and foremost. So I stopped filming and I took the shot. And this is the shot that I got.
So this was one of those panic shots. And often you can just tell from taking one look at the clouds that your window of opportunity will last mere minutes, sometimes even just seconds. So while there was no time to record a tutorial for this particular shot, keep watching.
Yeah, I got a good shot, but I didn't really film much tutorial for these guys, so we're gonna have to come back for sunrise tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
You up for that?
I think so.
Yeah, well, that's good, because I've got to get back anyway, because I've got to meet my dealer.
What kind of a dealer?
I'd rather not say. But you'll find out. You'll find out. Let's just go back to the camper.
So back at the campsite, it was time to make a transaction.
Wayne? Who is it?
Well, it's Gavin, obviously.
What do you want?
Well, I want that travel tripod you were telling me about.
Did you come alone?
Well, I mean, Amanda's in the camper, but yeah, there's nobody else around. Oh, brilliant. Right, thanks then.
Did you bring the money?
No. Well, what it is, right, I thought I would just PayPal it to you like last time.
If it's PayPal, there's going to be conditions.
Conditions? Like what?
I think tomorrow morning you take me for a sunrise shoot and teach me some photography lessons.
God, I can't be giving like free tips and lessons. I don't do that.
You do it all the time on YouTube.
Oh, you're right, actually, I do. All the time. Completely free of charge. All right, yeah, well, we're doing that then, but we're getting up at 5 a.m, all right?
All right.
All right. Nice t-shirt.
Nice flip-flops.
With that important business dealt with, the very next morning, all three of us hit the trail long before the sunrise. Unfortunately, I'd made the grievous error of trying to function competently before consuming my morning coffee. I had made a terrible mistake that would haunt me all throughout the day.
So last night, I obviously failed miserably to give you any kind of a tutorial or even explain my shot, because I literally had 2 to 3 minutes to get that shot. Sorry about that. But today I've come all the way back, well, all three of us have hiked all the way back, even though I forgot to put the stairs back up on my truck and dragged the stairs up a dirt road, and they're now destroyed. Totally ruined my day, but even with that, I still climbed up here to get you this shot. Before we left last night, I've basically circled the rim of this entire canyon and found a multitude of photogasmic compositions. But last night, just as we left, long after the light was just unusable, I found this beautiful composition. So I spotted this beautiful ridge, which then points straight down at the river bend. Absolutely glorious. So this was my first visit this morning. This is where I went straight to set up my shot, and I'll show you my composition in a second. Just over there, you can see the sun is just about to pop up over that ridge, and it's only got a little gap, so I might only have a couple of minutes of light, and I'm hoping that the light just licks all of these surfaces here. Now, I'll have to wait for it to get a bit higher before it hits the trees down in the valley there, so there is another gap for that. That might happen. I'll be a bit suicidal if it doesn't, but we'll see. Well, the sun is just about to pop up over that cloud, and then I should get an absolutely brilliant shot with this.
Kevin, I'm ready for my photo tips of the day. I think I want to learn how to do a pano. I saw your friend Brent doing some panos. It's pretty amazing. So I'm all ready. I got my equipment, my phone here, and all I have to do is push that button and just have to scan across the horizon. It's brilliant.
Right, well, I don't think you need any tips, do you? Brent's got you all sorted out.
It was pretty easy, actually.
Yeah.
But hey, thanks for the tip.
I didn't give you a tip. Anyway, so back to this shot.
The reason why I'd travelled so far was to film a tutorial for Chapter 3, Form and Flow, which is on sale right now. And what I thought I would do with this video is give you guys a free preview of the course on the topic of layering.
Right, so let me give you a good example of this whole concept of layering. So hopefully you can see it with that camera, maybe you can, I don't know, but right in front of me, what I'm looking at is a three-layer shot. Even though if you were to count every single element, every single ridge, there'd probably be 100. But you can really break it down and simplify it mentally into probably three layers. So what I have is my foreground, that's my first layer. Then I have my middle ground, that's my second layer. And then I have my background. That background, like I said, it might have 50 layers, really, if you were to count them. But for a photographer, for an artist, I'm just thinking in terms of either three layers, sometimes maybe five. So what I have in this foreground here is this beautiful ridge that snakes in from the left as a gorgeous leading line. And it's really striking, not just because of the shape, but because of the colors that you can see on this lovely little bit of brush there. So that is my first layer. That's what's pulling me into the scene. And then the next thing that you see is the river. You got this snaking river. I'll just brighten this up a little bit so you can see. You got the snaking river, so that's your mid-ground. And of course, you could say that this ridge of hoodoos here is on that same plane. It's that part of that same layer. And then beyond that, you have the mountains in the distance. And of course, that lovely snaking switchback winding road that trails off into the mountains. So it's got depth. It really makes you feel like you're going on a journey off into this shot. And so looking at it from here, it really is just three layers. And that's how I always try and think about my landscapes is, okay, what am I going to put in the foreground? What am I going to put in the middle ground? And what am I going to put in the background? And if you can think about that when you're composing your shots and really spend your time looking for that first layer, sometimes that's the most important part. If you put that time in, it'll pay dividends, because really, my main subject is the river there, but that's not going anywhere, right? Anywhere on this canyon, it's gonna kind of look the same unless I go to the other side of the canyon. So that's not going anywhere. What I can do though to draw attention to that second layer is look for something interesting in the foreground, such as this little ridge, and it really pulls you into that scene, creates depth, and ultimately takes you on a journey.
I was absolutely delighted with how this turned out. Well worth a ferry and a 10-hour drive. And in the end, I went for a much tighter crop, as it looked simpler and cleaner without that pointless sky. And if you're interested, Form and Flow is on sale now, but only for a few more days. And if you're not interested, well, here's another free tip for you.
So you can see that the sun is way off to my left of the frame there, and of course that's causing a lot of glare. Even though I have the lens hood on, it's so bright and it's at a certain angle that it's going to get in and cause this lens flare. You can see that lens flare there. So I'm just going to fix that so that when I take the shot, I get my hand and just block it. So I'm taking the shot and now I can take my hand away. So you'll see it came back. That's something to watch out for. Whenever you've got the sun off to one side, is just always use your hand or any accessory pack that you've got just to kind of block that light. And then always make sure, check the image back on playback, just to make sure that your hand didn't creep in. I can't tell you how many times I've seen my creeping finger. That sounds bad, doesn't it? Creeping finger.
All in all, this had been a really successful shoot, and I was delighted with the shots that I got, but the time had finally come for me to pay up on my deal with Wayne.
Oh, that is an absolutely tremendous shot, is that?
Hey, Gavin, I'm ready for my next photo tip. What's the best settings that I could have for this spectacular view?
Well, hang on, let me just enjoy my tofu stir fry. Just put it on A.
A? Mm. What does A stand for?
Awesome.
Awesome?
Yeah.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's the only tip.
I'm getting a little hungry.
What's that?
It's chocolate. Mountain chocolate.
Oh. Is that any good?
It's delicious. Would you like some chocolate?
Yeah, I won't mind, actually. It's kind of bland.
Well, I think maybe you need to give me a little bit of some proper tips.
Okay, ISO 100, F11, focus on that point down there. Do about a quarter of a second exposure, turn your polarizer, jobs are good. Oh, make sure you've got a 2-second timer and no mirror lockup.
But what's ISO?
Increasingly shitty outcome. Will that do for you?
Yeah, I think that's pretty good.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll have those then. Hope you like tofu.
But all good things must end. It was time to face my mistake.
So this is what happens when you you get up and you rush off when you're not fully awake. You make stupid mistakes. And I forgot to fold the stairs up. So we drove off and it stretched it out like a slide.
It's so, probably still usable.
Yeah? Hopefully, Wayne's got some tools that can maybe help fix this. I was right, Wayne did have some tools, and he knows how to use them.
Again, you know, if you're gonna do something like that though, there's conditions.
You've got a bit pissed off. What it is, I thought I'd just PayPal it to you like I did last time. Here.
Oh.
I just thought I'd PayPal it to you like last time. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, you need a good grip on this tug of war.
Did you bring the money?
It's like Frankenstein's front door. And you just kind of swing round in a weird way.
Did that hurt?
No.
Oh. It actually sounds pretty good.
PayPal? If it's gonna be PayPal, then there's consequences.
Consequences or conditions?
Who is it?
Well, it's Gavin, obviously.
What do you want?
Well, that travel tripod you were telling me about.
Brilliant!
A star is born.